This is episode 2 about the giraffe and the Pelly and me. We are the window cleaners, sang out the monkey. We will polish your glass till it's shining like brass and it sparkles like sun on the sea. We are quick and polite, we will come day or night, the giraffe and the Pelly and me. We're a fabulous crew, we know just what to do, and we never stop work to drink tea. All your windows will glow when we give them a go, the giraffe and the Pelly and me. We use water and soap, plus some kindness and help, but we never use ladders, not we. Who needs ladders at all when you're 30 feet tall? Not giraffe, not Pelly, and not me. I stood there enthralled. Then I heard a giraffe saying to the pelican in the next window, Pelly, my dear, be so good as to fly down and bring that small person up here to talk to us. At once the pelican spread his huge white wings and flew down onto the road beside me. Hop in, he said, opening his enormous beak. I stared at the great orange beak and backed away. Go on, the monkey shouted from up in his window. The Pelly isn't going to swallow you. Climb in. I said to the pelican, I'll only get in if you promise not to shut your beak once I'm inside. You have nothing to fear, cried the pelican. And let me tell you why. I have a very special beak. A special beak have I. You'll never see a beak so fine. I don't care where you go, there's magic in this beak of mine. Hop in and don't say no. I will not hop in, I said, unless you swear on your honor you won't shut it once I'm inside. I don't like small dark places. When I have done what I'm just about to do, said the pelican, I won't be able to shut it. You don't seem to understand how my beak works. Show me, I said. Watch this, cried the pelican. I watched in amazement as the top half of the pelican's beak began to slide smoothly backwards into his head until the whole thing was almost out of sight. It bends and goes down the back. It bends and goes down inside the back of my neck, cried the pelican. Is that not sensible? Is that not magical? It's unbelievable, I said. It's exactly like one of those tape measures my father's got at home. When it's out, it's straight. When you find it back in, it bends and disappears. Precisely, said the pelican. You see, the top half is of no use to me unless I'm chewing fish. The bottom half is what counts, my lad. The bottom half of this glorious beak of mine is the bucket in which we carry our window cleaning water. So if I didn't have to slide the top half away, I'd be standing around all day holding it open. So I slide it away for the rest of the day, even though I'm still able to talk. And wherever I've flown, it has always been known as the pelican's pattern to its beak. If I want to eat fish, that's my favorite dish, all I do is give it a tweak. In the blink of an eye, out pops and they cry, it's the pelican's panther hen's beak. Stop showing off down there, shouted the monkey from upstairs window. Hurry up and bring that small person up to us. The giraffe is waiting. I climbed into the big orange beak and with a whoosh, swoosh of wings, the pelican carried me back onto his perch on the windowsill. The giraffe looked out of her window at me and said, how do you do? What is your name? Billy, I told her. Well, Billy, she said, we need your help, and we need it fast. We must have some windows to clean. We've spent every penny we have on buying this house, and we must earn some more money quickly. The Pelly is starving, the monkey is famished, and I am perishing with hunger. The Pelly needs nuts, the Pelly needs fish, the monkey needs nuts, and I am even more difficult to feed. I am a geranious giraffe, and a geranious giraffe can't eat anything except the pink and purple flowers of the tinkle tinkle tree. But those, I think, I'm sure you know, are hard to find and expensive to buy. The pelican cried out, right now I am so hungry I could eat a stale sardine. Has anyone seen a stale sardine or a bucket of raw cod? I'd eat the whole lot upon the spot. I'm such a hungry bard. Every time the pelican spoke, the beak I was standing in jiggled madly up and down. The more excited he got, the more it jiggled. The monkey said, what Pelly's really crazy about is salmon. Yes, yes, cried the pelican. Salmon, oh, glorious salmon. I dreamed about it all day long, but I never get any.